for LaSalle. Inside, open Schmidt for the two. So and Tony Schmidt, sorry about
and
that.
And that travel outside, I mean, that was an obvious travel call, just missed by the officials.
10-8, LaSalle with the lead. Elder with the basketball. Out to Bovard. Bovard behind the arc. Goes at the top for Holmes. Left side, Beck. Now to Ratterman. Ratterman had it knocked away, but picks it back up. Goes to Rudolph. Way up for three. Rudolph doesn't hit. Ratterman tapped the rebound, but it's picked up by LaSalle's Bobby Off. Point lead now, 12-8, their biggest lead. 2:58 to play in the opening quarter. Ratterman the basketball, left side for Elder. Gets it into Rudolph in the paint. Rudolph spins, pulls up a jumper off the glass and in! Kyle Rudolph, a pretty shot. And Kendall Owens now, and trying to get the full court pressure here, setting up. And Kendall Owens will finally get it across the timeline with a drive. Knocked away, picked up by Elder. The other way is Ratterman. Ball Ratterman, the basketball. Pulls up, goes to Rudolph underneath. Rudolph tap is no good. The rebound tap, and LaSalle will pick it up, and it's Bobby Austin. Kendall Owens now will get it the right side. Now to Austin across the timeline. Austin right side for Vince Harris. Harris being guarded by Holmes, drives the baseline now, pulls up a shot, blocked by Holmes, and he picked it up the other way. It's Ratterman now crossing the timeline for Elder, into Rudolph. Rudolph left-hand shot, good, and the foul.
Yeah, and that's exactly what the Panthers are looking for, trying to get the ball inside to Rudolph, making the teams foul him, putting him at the line. All week he worked on his foul shots, and if he can start sinking those, he's an offensive and defensive threat.
Great point. And now Johnson moves to the left point. Gets it left side to Nolan. Nolan the basketball now goes right side for Johnson. 20 side jumper from 17. No good. Rebound tap. And it's Holmes has it for Elder. The other way. Up with it is Beck. Underneath for Rudolph. Doesn't go. And the rebound for Schmidt the other way for LaSalle. Setting up is Owens. Trying to cross the timeline here. 7 minutes to go. Quarter number two. Elder 17. LaSalle 16. Bounces it inside to McElroy for the layup. Is good. He now has six.
McElroy did a real good job getting to the other side of the rim on that.
McElroy sets up now. 18-17 LaSalle with the lead here. Ratterman the basketball for Elder. Going inside to Rudolph. Trying to get the mismatch. Pulls up from 15. Jumper good. So Rudolph now with 9 points to lead the way for the Panthers. And Elder leads it 19-18. With 6:28 to play in the second quarter, and we'll take a quick timeout, just a 20-second timeout. Actually, we'll keep it right here, Phil. But a great first start for this game, and you look at Elder leading by one. It's been back and forth, but they're taking advantage of Rudolph's height.
They really are pounding into Rudolph, but one thing that hasn't really been, probably you don't think about as much, is Nick Holmes inside. Nick Holmes in the first quarter was guarded by Bobby Austin a whole heck of a lot, and they just kept pounding it into Holmes. There's about a 4-inch difference between the two, and Holmes was able to get 4 buckets. They got a different guy guarding him now. I'm not exactly sure who it is. I believe it's Sean. I can't remember who was in there on him. I think they kind of switched McElroy on him because that's a better matchup, but then who's guarding Rudy?
Right. You got to get Rudy in there, and he's certainly done a great job tonight. Already with 9 points, Nick Holmes has 4. Steve Hengold with 2. Danny Beck with 2. And Paul Ratterman with 2. McElroy with 6 leads the way for LaSalle. Bring it up right to left for LaSalle. The Lancers setting up his Posey. Posey has yet to score in this game. Drives the lane, and he's going to get a foul. It's going to be a blocking foul. And setting up here with 6 minutes and 19 seconds to go in the second quarter.
Fouls on Johnny Bovard. That's his second.
And setting up underneath the basket, left side is Hennessy will inbound. Gets it to Austin, goes back to Hennessy. Hennessy drives on Rudolph, not going to get anything there. They thought there was a travel. McElroy jumper is no good. Rebound Rudolph the other way. Rudolph gets it right side now up to Ratterman. Now to Beck. Beck drives the lane. Good move, and they'll get the foul. That was a great move. He thought it looked like Posey was going to get him there, but he wound up going up and getting the foul.
Danny Beck drove in on the play. He got to the block, came to a nice clean jump stop, put a real good shot fake up, waited till he was in the air, and then went up and drew the foul.
Danny Beck's left-hand free throw is up and good. That's 3 points now for Danny Beck in the game. 6:04 to play in this, the second quarter. Elder leading it 20-18 now by 2. And the left-hand free throw is up and no good. Rebound tapped, and Elder gets it back. It's set up by Ratterman. Now open jumper for Johnson for three. Doesn't go. Rebound for Smith the other way for LaSalle. Tony Schmidt with the basketball. Left-hand dribble. Gets it right side now to McElroy. Over is Brendan Jones. Actually, check that. That's Vince Harris. And he had it knocked away. Stolen the other way. Kevin Johnson. Left side now Ratterman. Ratterman pulls up for Elders. Now at the top for Beck. Beck on the left side. Goes right side to Johnson. Kevin Johnson now with the left-hand dribble. Pulls to the top. Bounces it to Rudolph behind the arc. Rudolph now right side to Beck for three. It bounces in. Oh, that looked like it was bouncing out. A three-pointer. Danny Beck now with 6 points. And Elder with their biggest lead, 23-18 now, with 5:15 to go in the second quarter. Bobby Austin goes right side now to McElroy with the left side pass to Vince Harris. Harris right-hand dribble goes to Bobby Austin on the right side. Austin from 16, jumper no good. Rebound tapped is Ratterman. Ratterman open, Rudolph pulls up layup. Good! What a shot by Kyle Rudolph. That is now 11 for Kyle Rudolph. 25-18, Elder with the lead. McElroy thought he traveled, no call. Vince Harris blocked away by Holmes, picked up the other way, and Elder gets it back into Rudolph again with a reverse layup is good. Kyle Rudolph now with 13 points for the Elder Panthers, and the lead is 9, 27-18.
And Dan Fleming is not showing any emotion on this right now, this little drive.
And there's a foul by Danny Beck, but what a run for Kyle Rudolph. 13 points already, and with 4:29 to go, Elder leads at 27-18.
It was a nice little run there by the Panthers, and a couple of things that really got into it was when LaSalle went inside, the Panthers had active hands, and they were able to get a quick steal, kick it out to Rudolph, and just there, that little cheap foul, Danny Beck bought a shot fake, and that got him to the line.
Got him some rest, and Vince Harris missed the free throw. Vince with 4 points in the game for LaSalle. Setting up now, going to get some substitutions. Kendall Owens will come in for LaSalle, taking Tony Schmidt's place, who's been very quiet in this game. Steve Hengold replaces Kyle Rudolph, and he hears it from the crowd. 13 points for Kyle Rudolph as he takes a seat. A well-deserved little break. And setting up Vince Harris now. Again, the free throw is up. No good. Missed them both. And sets up the other way. Hengold with the rebound. Up to Kevin Johnson. 4:22 to go in the second quarter. Elder with their biggest lead, 27-18. And there's a foul. That's going to be on Bobby Austin. And Bobby Austin picks up number one for LaSalle. That's their second team foul. And picking up underneath, it'll be Danny Beck will inbound. And he'll set it up behind the line. It'll be Kevin Johnson. He'll have to cross the timeline now. And Kevin does with 4:10 to play in the second quarter. Danny Beck the basketball. Elder leads it 27-18. Left side Holmes. Holmes to Ratterman. Ratterman right side to Beck. Beck the basketball for the Elder Panthers. 3:58 to go in the second quarter. Setting up is Kevin Johnson. Goes to Ratterman. Inside for Holmes. Off the glass and in! What a shot by Holmes. What a pass. And Holmes now has six. 29-18 Elder with an 11-point lead as LaSalle led 18-17 in this one. So it's been all Elder, 12-0 run here. Okay, setting up now at the top is Kendall Owens. 3.5 to play in the second quarter. Setting up right side is McElroy. McElroy bounce pass up to Austin. Inside's got Hennessy. Hennessy double team. Open Kendall Owens for three. No good. Rebound tapped, and LaSalle has gone ice cold in this one. Ratterman with the rebound. Up now to Holmes. Right side to Beck, and it knocked away. Kendall Owens knocked it away. Elder will keep it. Coming in the ballgame as Patrick Nolan will give Ratterman a rest. And Elder with an 11-point lead in this one.
Yeah, it's really been a huge turnaround for the Panthers. At first, it looked like they were going to have a lot of trouble when they just started pushing the ball up and down the court and playing tight defense. And they've really been able to develop a lead here.
Danny Beck with the basketball gets it to Patrick Nolan. And Nolan will sit up going right side to Kevin Johnson. Into Rudolph, who just checked in. And Rudolph now with 15 points for the Panthers here in the first half. And Elder leads it 31-18, a 13-point lead. But a 14-0 run for the Panthers. Setting up now. Here's good move. Inside is good. Kendall Owens, but let's see. They're going to say no basket.
No basket. Steve Hengold stuck up, stepped up, took a huge charge to create a turnover there by the Lancers, which puts the ball right back in Elder's court, and also the momentum stays with the Panthers.
2:47 to go in the second quarter. Elder 31, LaSalle 18. It was 15-14 after one. Elder with a one-point lead. They lead it here. And setting up now for the Elder Panthers, Kevin Johnson. Johnson, the basketball, goes left side to Beck. Beck on the left point, looks for some help, goes right side now, switches up, looking still with the basketball with 2:28 to play in the second quarter. Elder 31, LaSalle 18, and get a five-second violation on Beck, and there, of course, Schoenfeld did not like that one.
And well, the reason why is the official closest to him held his hands out at his side, which means they're not counting. The official opposite the court was counting. So the guy closest to Danny Beck was been telling him, I'm not counting. And then he gets a five-second call. That's what the why Joe Schoenfeld was so upset.
Setting up right side now is Posey. Posey, the basketball, the left-hand dribble. Setting up right side now as Schmidt pulls up at the foul line. The jumper bounces in. So Tony Schmidt now with 6 points for LaSalle. And that ends the run. And it looks like Elder wants to talk it over. 31-20 with 2:03 to play. We'll take a timeout on the Prep Sports Radio Network.
What is your problem? I can't go with you.
I don't know what Fleming's doing here. He's looking for a five-second call, but
I really don't want to take him because I'm.
Okay. I know. Yeah. But we're gonna do one. Anyway.
All right.
I don't know.
Bring a fresh new look to your home or business with quality paint job by the Richardson and Schneider Paint Company. Richardson and Schneider Paint Company will bring ideas, your ideas, to life. Give them a call at 513-324-1321. That's 513-324-1321. And right now with 2:03 to go here in the second quarter, it's been all Elder. They lead it 31-20.
It has been a huge turn of events. At the beginning of this game, it looked like LaSalle was going to come out and really give some trouble to the Panthers offensively and defensively. And then Elder just took over and was able to go on that nice little run. And they're still on it, really, because LaSalle, I think, only has scored two in that little run.
Setting up now is Ratterman for the Panthers with 1:55 to go. Right side is Johnson. At the top is Ratterman on the right point. Right side Johnson into Rudolph. Back to Johnson for a right point. Three. Good.
And that was a nice crack back by Kyle Rudolph. Rudolph caught it in the lane and kicked it right back out to KJ.
And that's his first 3 points of the ball game. And Elder leads it 34-20. A minute and a half to play here in the second quarter. Posey, the basketball for LaSalle with a left-hand dribble. Pulls up foul line jumper. Doesn't go. Barely touched the rim. Rudolph gets it back the other way. Rudolph bounce pass to Patrick Nolan. Nolan goes left side to Ratterman for three. Is good!
Big walk-up three for Paul Ratterman on that play.
Ratterman with five. It's 37-20. Elder on top. They have been dominating here in the second quarter. Setting up right side now is Austin. Left side for Schmidt. Schmidt pulls up from 17. Jumper is good. So Tony Schmidt now has 8 points in the ball game, and it's 37-22.
It wasn't an easy jumper.
Not at all.
Nolan had his hand up right in his face.
Johnson goes to Nolan with 43 seconds. Now to Rudolph, left side Johnson. Into Rudolph. Rudolph going in, but had it knocked away. But there's going to be a foul. That's going to go on Vince Harris of LaSalle. So Rudolph will get a chance for some more.
Kevin Johnson was over by the three-point line. Kyle Rudolph just made a simple basket cut, dished it off. I think Elder was trying to hold for a last shot, but they'll take anything. You know, they're looking for a layup on that play.
38.5 seconds inbounding the ball as Nolan gets it up to Ratterman. Ratterman drives the lane, running left-hander is up and good. So Paul Ratterman now with 7, and Elder 39, LaSalle 22 with 25 seconds now in this one. Second quarter, and Owens the basketball. Owens for LaSalle, driving in, pulling up from 15, jumper is good. So Kendall Owens gets his first two. It's 39-24 now. Right side, Nolan. Nolan with 10 seconds now. Left side, gets it up to Ratterman. Ratterman with 7 seconds for three, doesn't go. Rebound tapped by Nolan Owens, and it's going to go to Elder. Holmes with 1 second, up, no good. And that is the end of the first quarter, first half of play with the score. Elder 39 and LaSalle 24. Will take a timeout and come back on the Prep Sports Radio Network.
All right. That's our halftime report. Now I'm going to hand it back to the voice of the Elder Panthers, the man with the plan. Here's Rockin' Lenny Harvey.
Thank you, Mr. Bengal. And we're getting ready for the start of the third quarter with Elder with the lead, 39-24. 24 points in the second quarter. And we start the third quarter with Elder going from right to left, and they get the inbounds pass. Ratterman will now cross the timeline for the Panthers, setting up here. And now right side up with Danny Beck. Goes to Ratterman. Ratterman the basketball. Ratterman to Beck. Beck into Holmes. Holmes had it knocked away and it's stolen and picked up the other way. LaSalle with Posey. Posey the basketball. Goes right side to McElroy. Setting up at the top is Austin. Right side Schmidt. Now up to Posey. Posey now open jumper for Austin. It's good. Is that three? It is a three for Bobby Austin. That is now seven for Bobby Austin. And 7:20 to play in the third. It's 39-27.
LaSalle switched to a 2-3 zone.
Setting up now the Panthers. Ratterman slowing up a bit. Going into Rudolph who threw it to nobody. Nobody to the right side. It looked like a little misread.
Kyle passed over to the side. Johnny Bovard was there calling for it, but he proceeded to cut through along the baseline. Was no longer there when he turned.
Posey will set it up for the LaSalle Lancers. Setting up left side is Danny Schmidt, the other Schmidt in the ballgame. Left side and knocked away. Good play by the Elder Panthers, picked up by Rudolph. And now the other way to Beck. Beck over to Bovard. Right side Rudolph. He had almost had a travel there. Gets it to Ratterman for three. He's good. Paul Ratterman now has 10. 42-27. Elder on top by 15 now. Setting up Posey the other way. Knocked away Austin, but he picks it up. Goes to Posey. And Posey setting up now. Going left side to Bobby Austin. Right side is Schmidt. Up to Tony Schmidt. The other Schmidt now gets it to Bobby Austin for three, and he hits again. That's now 10 points for Bobby Austin. Very quickly, Phil, Elder leads at 42-30, but LaSalle go into that play.
And Fleming just took a 30-second timeout here real quick. I'm not quite sure why, but the momentum switch to LaSalle's side. They ran two quick plays. Bobby Austin first was a bunch of dribble handoffs right across the top. They handed it off about three times. Bobby Austin then was open because Elder's defense was all over the place. This last play was a double screen coming out with Austin coming out top. That creates mismatches for the defense because you don't know if you're the big guy. Should I hedge out? Should I switch? So you're looking kind of playing. I think coming out next possession, I don't see that double screen being as effective the next time it's ran. But that is actually the first time LaSalle's actually taking time in the half court to run a play.
6:17 to go in the third quarter. Elder leads it 42-30. Elder will inbound, having to go the length of the floor. Danny Beck will inbound, gets it to Kyle Rudolph, and Rudolph will have to cross the timeline. Rudolph leading the way with 15 points for Elder, crossing the timeline now. Pulls up at the foul line, the jumper, no good. Rebound tapped. Rudolph gets it back. Rudolph pulls up from 10, no good, but there's a foul. Great hustle by Kyle Rudolph doing it all.
He's just padding his stats, you know. He's trying to miss that rebound, miss that shot, get the rebound, put it up. Then he gets 2 points and a rebound.
Not bad.
But that's one threat that you do at the lookout with Kyle Rudolph is the fact that he's 6'7". Normally a 6'7" guy you wouldn't think could bring the ball up the court, but he brings it up pretty handily.
His free throw up in the right hand, and it is good. So Kyle Rudolph now with 16 points for the Elder Panthers. They lead it 43-30. They led 39-24 at the half. And sets up Rudolph now. The free throw is up. This one is no good. The rebound for Hennessy the other way. Picks up Posey. Posey will cross the timeline now with 5:55 to play here in the third. Posey drives the lane. Running left-hander, no good. But a foul is called. I believe they're going to get John Bovard on that one.
Basically on that play, what you're looking at, Posey drove right down the middle of the lane, went straight up, and Bovard just got him with the body. He bailed out the jump shooter, but there wasn't really much he could do to get out of the way.
Posey looking for his first two, and it's no good. Posey normally averages 5.2 points per game, but right now. Sorry, Phil. But 5:53 to go here in the third. Elder with a 43-30 lead, and Posey setting up with his left hand. His second free throw is up and no good. He missed them both. The rebound underneath for LaSalle. Up, no good. Rebound tap. And McElroy had a chance, but it's picked up by Elder. Kevin Johnson.
The rebound was tapped by Kyle Rudolph.
And it's up now for Beck. Beck into Rudolph for the easy two. Doesn't go this time. Bounces off the rim. And the rebound comes out for Posey. 5:35 to go. Third quarter. Elder 43. LaSalle 30. Right side is McElroy. Up now to Austin. Left side. Gets it into Posey. Posey drives off the glass and in. So nice move by Posey with the left hand and gets it in with 5:18 to play in the third. 43-32. Elder with the lead. Right side setup now for the Panthers is Rudolph at the foul line. Looks for help. Setting up now. Here's Kevin Johnson. Johnson the basketball for the Panthers. Steps on the Panther logo. Goes right side now to Ratterman. Slowing it up a bit, I notice here in the third quarter. For Elder. Setting up is Rudolph behind the arc. Bounce pass to Holmes, had it knocked away, and it's picked up underneath. Johnson gets it up. Open three. Danny Beck doesn't go. Rebound for LaSalle. Tony Schmidt. Schmidt the other way. Crossing the timeline. Left side. Setting up Posey. Now gets it back. Schmidt running one-hander. No good. Rebound Rudolph the other way. So Elder will get it back from right to left they go. Right side is Ratterman. Ratterman drives the lane. Running one-hander is no good. Rebound Holmes tapped, but no. It's McElroy. For LaSalle, Posey now gets it, crossing the timeline. From left to right, LaSalle goes with 4:20 to play in the third. It's 43-32, Elder on top. It's Danny Schmidt at the top, goes right side for McElroy, right to Posey, top to Schmidt, that's Tony Schmidt. Left side, Bobby Austin, who's been hot here in the second, drives the lane, shot no good, rebound tapped underneath. Rudolph gets the rebound though and goes to the right side for Kevin Johnson. He crosses the timeline. Now bounce pass, Danny Beck thought about a three, doesn't take it, gets it to Johnson, left side, Rudolph, top of the key, three, doesn't go, rebound underneath, it's Holmes gets it, Holmes now, Ratterman, open, three, good!
That was a nice rebound by Nick Holmes. He actually got tied up on that play and was able to come out with it before the referee could signal a jump ball.
Ratterman with 13, 46-32, Elder. On top with 3.5 to play here in the third. Posey from 17 doesn't go. Rebound for Holmes. Gets it up the right side now to Ratterman. Underneath to Rudolph, but it knocked away. It'll stay Elder Panther basketball, though. So Elder with a 46-32 lead. They've done everything right in this game.
Steve Hangold checks in for Kyle Rudolph to get him a much-needed rest. Steve Hangold, the nice thing about this system, Steve Hangold is not going to drop any sort of playing talent or effort level at all.
Underneath the be the right side of the backboard. And Danny Beck will inbound for the Elder Panthers. Looks, trying to get it in, and finally does to Hangold. He stepped out of bounds. So it'll be a turnover for the Panthers, and LaSalle will get it.
And Elder kind of was looking for the man to come off the second screen out there on the wing, but he was guarded, so they tried to get a quick duck in with Steve Hangholm, but he just happened to step on the line.
Tony Schmidt brings it up for LaSalle, goes right side now to Austin. Austin, left side, Kendall Owens. Owens drives the lane, good pass underneath. Harris up, no good, but a foul is called, so Harris will get a chance to give LaSalle some points here. 46-32 Elder with 3:08 to play here in the third.
And that's that ball movement that's really key for the Lancers. They moved it around real quick. Kendall Owens drove the lane and got it over to Harris, and he put up a quick shot before Elder could get in position.
And the free throw is up and good, so Vince Harris now has 5 for the Lancers. 46-33.
Kyle Rudolph checks back in for Nick Holmes.
And setting up here, Vince Harris will get another chance to shoot a free throw here as Posey comes back in. Schmidt takes a seat.
McElroy entered the game as well.
Yeah, he's been in and out.
And I think he's needed in there because they had a small lineup, so they had to get a 6'7 guy back in there to guard Kyle Rudolph, 6'7.
And the free throw by Vince Harris is up and good. 6 now for Harris. And LaSalle trails 46-34. Elder brings it up. Rudolph back in the game. Trying to cross the timeline, gets it to Johnson. Johnson with the basketball to Ratterman. Ratterman now setting up the Elder offense. Bounce pass to Rudolph and double team. Stolen away and picked up by LaSalle. Bobby Austin had it, gets it to Posey. Posey sets up LaSalle now with 2:43 to go in the third. Elder 46 and LaSalle 34. Left side is Owens. Owens to Posey. Posey with Johnson right on top of him, not giving up anything with 2.5 now to play in the third. Posey drives, and the shot is good. Devere Posey with his 4 points now, and it's 2:20 to play in the third, 46-36 now. LaSalle to within 10. Right side Johnson, a little press now for LaSalle. They get it to Rudolph crossing the timeline, but Elder wants to talk it over with 2:14 to go in the third. It's Elder 46 and LaSalle 36. Will take a timeout on the Prep Sports Radio Network.
All right.
Oh, he's got that. Okay, I was going to do the live read, but he's doing the... Well, Lynn Harvey and Phil Bengel back here at Elder High School with Elder leading at 46-36 here and setting up what is a great game here tonight because Elder's done everything right, but LaSalle getting back into this game, though, 46-36.
And what has happened is simply LaSalle changed one thing. They changed their defense. They couldn't guard Rudolph inside man-to-man because at the same time they still can't guard Paul Ratterman outside or Johnny Bovard outside. They have now switched to a 2-3, which Elder has gone down the court now and turned the ball over 3 times in a row, and LaSalle has gone down and hit 2 big shots to bring them back within to bring this game back to a 10-pointer.
Danny Beck gets the ball from Johnson. They set it up for the Panthers now. Beck the basketball going left side now to Kevin Johnson. Johnson at the top is Ratterman. Inside Rudolph, the hook shot won't go. Tap rebound and Elder, let's see. No, it's LaSalle getting it back and Vince Harris.
There's a lot of battling going on inside there. And Rudolph and Hanghold both went at it with McElroy and Harris.
1:50 to go in the third. McElroy with the basketball. Going right side to Posey. Posey pulls up, no good, but a foul. They're going to get Kyle Rudolph on the foul there. It looked like he got all ball.
And that's one of those things that Joe Schoenfeld right now is pointing the other side of the court. Some of the fans are kind of making some noise, but the same thing just happened down underneath the Elder basket. Normally GCL officials like to let guys play, but they need to play consistently or there's going to be, you know, some real problems just both ways. It always usually in the GCL happens where it's not just one team. It'll be calls. It'll go both ways. So LaSalle will probably see something here soon similar to that.
And that free throw is no good. Coach Fleming talking it over with McElroy. He's trying to set up a play here after the shot defensively. And the free throw is up. Man, this one is good. So Posey now has 5 points. And Elder lead is 9, 46-37. Into Rudolph, stolen away by LaSalle, picking up with it is Posey. He drives, had it knocked away the other way. Johnson has it for Elder. Bounce pass to Ratterman. Ratterman, a good move. And now sets it up to Kevin Johnson with 1:25 to go in the third. Elder 46, LaSalle 37. Setting up is Beck. Beck the basketball. Goes left side to Hanghold. Now up to Danny Beck. Beck the basketball. Goes in now to Hanghold. Right side is Johnson. Johnson pulls up right-handed. 3 is no good. And the rebound, Rudolph underneath. Tapped and picked up by Ratterman. Ratterman underneath to Rudolph. Off the glass and in with the left hand.
And Kyle Rudolph inside is really starting to develop an attitude of that, get me the ball and I'm going to score. They've tried to get into him twice now and he's gone up strong. And that's really going to hurt the Lancers.
Well, the attitude has given him 18 points tonight. 48-37, Elder, and a foul away from the hope. They're going to call a timeout by LaSalle. Now, the Elder Supply Store did a good job through the Christmas holidays. They're open Monday through Thursday from 10:30 till 1 o'clock, and that's Monday through Thursday. And keep in mind, check out the Elder Supply Store right in front of the pit always when you come to every day. That's 10:30 to 1 p.m. Monday through Thursday. That's the normal hours.
And it's normally open. There'll be a sign out front. Come on in, get all your Elder stuff. I know Christmas is around, coming around the corner, and you know, maybe you look at and you say that it's just too late to buy somebody something from the Elder Supply Store. It's never too late to give a gift from the Elder Supply Store.
Setting up 48-37 here, and You know, LaSalle's done a pretty good job here in the third quarter of getting back into this game, down 39-24. Elder has been outscored in this third quarter as of not only 9 points for the Panthers here. LaSalle, meanwhile, has scored 13. So 13-9 run. Pretty good job by LaSalle setting up here. Good adjustments by Coach Fleming.
And I'd say the only problem, though, with their run is the fact that they haven't shut down Kyle Rudolph yet. With Kyle Rudolph being in the game and being able to pound it inside, the problems you run into is getting your shooters into foul trouble. When you got McElroy, if you get him into foul trouble guarding Rudolph inside, you lose a shooter.
Here is an open shot. Austin for three, and that's his third three of this half. He now has 13, and Bobby Austin gives it a 48-40 lead for Elder. So only 8 points as Bobby Austin now with 10.
And it's been a very quiet 10.
Well, 13, I'm sorry.
13. It's been a very quiet 13. He really hasn't been making a whole lot of big plays until late now.
Setting up is Rudolph now for Elder, having to go the length of the floor with 35 seconds to play here in the third. Here's Rudolph now crossing the timeline. Left side is Beck. Beck looking for help, goes right side to Johnson, who's got a lot of play here in the third. He gets it to Beck. We're down to 22 seconds to play here in the third. 48-40, Elder on top. Here's Johnson, the basketball for the Elder Panthers. Right side down to 12 seconds. Left to Ratterman. Ratterman, a foul is called, and that's going to be on Kendall Owens for LaSalle.
And one thing I keep watching down here, for you know, people at home never get to experience Dan Fleming in all his glory, and Dan is notorious for slapping his shoe, and I'm sure you're hearing it on the mic. That's his way of getting his players' attention. It's not because he's angry. He's just getting their attention instead of having to scream, but he always loses his voice by the end of the game.
Setting up right side is Beck. Beck the basketball. Now left side, Ratterman for three. That doesn't go. The rebound underneath with 1 second. That'll do it. That is the end of three quarters of play with the score. Elder 48 and LaSalle 40. We'll take a timeout on the Prep Sports Radio Network.
What's the matter? You're going to go in your pants?
Oh, no, I'm not. I'm
out. Go downstairs and go to the bathroom. You know where it is. Go run.
Okay.
Sounds good.
And LaSalle brings it in and gets it up to Schmidt. Danny Schmidt gets it inside to Bobby Austin to start the fourth quarter. Going left side now is Posey. Posey the basketball with the right side, drives the lane. Running left-hander, no good, tapped up, no good by McElroy. And they're going to get a foul, look like, or could it be a turnover? And Coach Fleming is, he can't contain himself.
They're calling it over the back, and it was a legitimate over-the-back call. Kyle Rudolph went up straight, and McElroy came right in and just kind of made contact and actually tried to go for a tip dunk and happened to meet the ball with the rim instead of putting it through the hoop.
Setting up is Ratterman for Elder. Goes to Rudolph. Right side, Danny Beck. Beck the basketball. Setting up now at the top is Bovard. Bovard sets up and they're going to get another turnover. It looked like a travel.
They called an illegal screen on Nick Holmes out top, trying to screen the zone. He stuck his leg out, and they got an illegal screen called.
7:22 to go here in the fourth, and this one don't go anywhere. 48-40, Elder on top. Setting up now. Gets it up to Austin. Now up to Danny Schmidt inside. He's got McElroy. Pulls up jumper. Good! McElroy now. He now has 8. And McElroy gives it 2, 48-42 now, down to 6. Here's Beck, got fouled, going up.
And the Panthers immediately, right after that play, grabbed the ball and took off down the sideline and tried to get a quick score. They're going to put Danny Beck at the foul line after that play. But going back to the basket by the Lancers, it was a nice shot fake in there by McElroy that was able to get Rudolph off his feet. But the problem was he didn't go into him. If you want to get Rudolph in foul trouble, you're going to have to make some contact or he's going to be out there the whole game.
48-42, Elder by six, 6:57 to go here in the fourth quarter. On the free throw line is Danny Beck.
And Dan Fleming's hot about this, saying he wasn't shooting, but Danny Beck was fouled in the air as the ball when he was in a shooting motion.
Beck has six and looks to add to it and misses the free throw. And Danny Beck will get another chance here with 6:57 to go here in the fourth. His left-hand free throw is up, and it is good. So Beck now with seven, and Elder's lead is seven, 49-42. Setting up LaSalle the other way. Posey, the basketball with a left-hand dribble. Pulls up foul line jumper. Good. So Posey now has seven, and Elder's lead is five. Bringing it up the other way is Bovard. Bovard double team, gets it to Radiman. Right side Rudolph now to Beck. Beck looks for some help, and another turnover by the Panthers.
3 seconds. Nick Holmes is just camping out in the lane. He's got to move out of there. I mean, that's a turnover that will really hurt the Panthers in the long run of this game. Right now, only being a five-point game.
6:30 to play here in the fourth. 49-44. It's been LaSalle's game here in the second half. Setting up left side Posey. Goes into McElroy. McElroy drives on Rudolph. No good, but a foul is called. And McElroy starting to feel it underneath.
And I'll tell you what, the one thing that simply amazes me is on that play, by the time McElroy went up and made that foul and got the foul call, Dan Fleming was at the elbow ready to congratulate him. Really, in this situation, Dan Fleming, from a coach's perspective, has got to start watching himself because he could cost himself, his team, a costly technical foul for being out on the court.
McElroy free throw is no good. Coach Fleming calling out a seven for his play here on the defensive end. And the free throw is up, and it's good. So McElroy now with nine, and Elder leads it by only four, 49-45. This is a team that led 39-24 at the half. They've only scored 10 points here in the second half. Meanwhile, LaSalle has scored 21. Setting up the right side is Rudolph trying to set up the Elder offense. Gets it to Ratterman trying to cross the timeline. Does to Beck, to Rudolph. Bounce into Holmes. Shot is no good, but a foul. And Holmes will get a chance on the line.
Simple thing happened there. Kyle Rudolph was able to get the ball up the court, got trapped, kicked it back to Paul Ratterman, and then it just went from there. They kicked it right back up the court as LaSalle kind of tried to run and jump, and that's what they've been trying to do this whole quarter, run and jump on the Panthers, but Elder's been able to get down to get some layups. They just got to start putting in their free throws.
And Nick Holmes will get a chance here. Nick Holmes has done a good job, and the free throw is up and good. That's 7 points now for Holmes. 6:08 to play here in the fourth. Elder leads it 50-45. And sets up now underneath the basket. And sets up a free throw is good. So Holmes now has eight. Sets up the other way is Bobby Austin. 51-45, Elder with 6 minutes to play here in the fourth. Posey for LaSalle. Goes left side to Harris. Now to Tony Schmidt for three. That bounces, no good. Rebound tapped up and in. That was Bobby Austin, who now has 15.
And that's exactly what the Lancers do well, is they crash the offensive boards. Elder had nobody to block out on that play.
Beck gets it up the top for Ratterman. Three doesn't go. Rebound underneath. Tapped out of bounds. It'll be LaSalle basketball. They're starting to feel it now, Phil.
Well, this is not the type of game the Panthers need to get in with the Lancers. The Lancers are very good at pushing the ball off the court and getting three-point shots on what's called a walk-up three, where you drive in a lane, somebody just walks up to the three-point line, not being guarded, and gets a wide-open one. They're very good at hitting those type of shots.
Elder 51, LaSalle 47. Setting up now, Tony Schmidt goes up to Bobby Austin to the right side. Back to Schmidt, left-hand shot, no good. Rebound Rudolph. Elder has it the other way. From right to left. Getting it up the other way is Beck. Beck at the left point goes inside to Holmes. Holmes turns in the paint, off the glass, and in! Nick Holmes now, he has 10.
And that was a great up and under move by Nick Holmes. He faked up, and then he went right underneath him when he went in the air.
53-47, Elder by 6. 5 minutes to play in the fourth. Setting up Schmidt to the top, goes right side to Austin. Inside McElroy on the line. And they're going to get a foul, I believe, on Nick Holmes there on the corner.
I think they might be giving a foul. They're giving a foul to Kyle Rudolph. They're saying he pushed him with his body, pushed him out of bounds on the drive.
And setting up here with 4:56 to play in the fourth. Underneath is Tony Schmidt to the right side of the backboard. Half-court offense for LaSalle to Posey. Posey, the basketball on the left side. Now Posey looks, goes right side to Harris. Harris, top of the circle, goes to Posey to the left point. Posey still with it with 4:42 to play. McElroy underneath. Inside, the shot off the glass, no good. Rebound Holmes, good defense by Holmes. The other way, Ratterman. Ratterman to Bovard. Layup off the glass, no good. Rudolph up and in.
Kyle Rudolph with a big tip in on that play. Johnny Bovard drove the lane, missed it off the front, and he was right there to tip it in for two. That's a big play for the Panthers.
4:29 to go in the fourth. We'll take a timeout. Elder 55, LaSalle 47 on the Prep Sports Radio Network.
A third. Okay. All right. Lenny, 30 second. Coming back cold.
Yeah. Well, Len Harvey and Phil Bengel back here at Elder High School. It's a very noisy place, and Elder leads it 55-47. But LaSalle has done a good job here in the second half, down 39-24 at the half, but yet they're within 8 points right now.
And it's become a very electric place. Both the LaSalle and the Elder fans have gotten into the game. They've gotten on every call, every single thing that is happening, which is what you want to see, and which is very stereotypical of a GCL matchup. Last week we saw Elder against Mullen. I'm sure the same way LaSalle and X. It's a loud gym. It's hard to concentrate. You got to do what you do best and run your plays with precision.
Tony Schmidt will bring it up for the Lancers with 4:22 to play here in the fourth. Gets it to Posey. Here's Austin, who's had the hot hand with three three-pointers here in the second half. Danny Schmidt gets it upside. Danny Schmidt now gets it over the right side to Posey. Posey, right side is Schmidt. Schmidt into Austin. Austin from 17. Good.
And then Austin just simply squared up against Paul Ratterman, looked him in the eye, and said, I'm going to make this shot right in front of you, and he did.
17 now for Bobby Austin, and Elder leads it 55-49. Here's Rudolph. Gets it right side to Beck. Beck the basketball with a left-hand dribble. Setting up now. Goes to the left side is Ratterman. Now to Beck. Beck steps up at the foul line to Rudolph, but there's a foul, and I believe they're going to get, let's see. It looked like it was on McElroy.
McElroy got him with a little bit of a push as Kyle caught the ball up top. And they're not in the bonus just yet, so it's going to be underneath.
Underneath, and Elder setting up the offense underneath is Bovard. And he bounces it into Rudolph, and the hook shot is good!
Kyle Rudolph, big play on the duck in there, a little pick the picker for the money basket.
22 for Kyle Rudolph to lead the way. 57-49, Elder with 3:25 now to play here in the fourth. Here's Posey. Right side, Austin for three. Had it blocked by Rudolph and out of bounds off of LaSalle.
And that's an amazing, that's what you call court awareness. That's something that'll get a coach madder than anything. It's the fact that the shot was blocked by Elder, yet McElroy tries to grab it when he cannot, tips it, Elder ball.
Elder ball, 57-49, and following many of the Friday night games, you can join the Prep Sports crew live at the Oasis Grill, located at 1270 Ebenezer. Not tonight, but the Oasis has great food. You can go over there anyway. Appetizers, but best of all, family fun to meet after the games. That's the Oasis Sports Grill and Pub at Ebenezer, just north of Cleese, Warsaw. We won't have the wrap-up show tonight, but they're open. Go over, have a couple of drinks, a couple of eats. Good stuff.
Definitely a great place to go. Good atmosphere. Go have some fun.
Absolutely. And right, of course, getting ready. Of course, Phil, got to get those last-minute Christmas shopping done.
Yep, tomorrow.
I want to go out Sunday night and get interviewed. You know, I always like those people that are on talking at Sunday night,
Christmas.
Yeah, about like 6 o'clock right at the mall when they close.
Yeah,
just start shopping then.
Even at tomorrow. Tomorrow is going to be the scary day.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's going to be the absolutely scary day. It's crazy people, minivans everywhere, last-minute shopping. You might as well just walk from your house.
Absolutely. I think if you go about 5 o'clock on Sunday night, right before they close, probably get the best deals.
You might run into the rest of the late-nighters.
Oh, that could be. Everybody's thinking the same way. 3:21 to play here in the fourth. Elder with the basketball and the lead, 57-49. Setting up now. Ratterman for Elder. Trying to get it across the line, does to Rudolph. Rudolph triple team, right side. Bovard for three, bounces out. Rebound underneath, it's good. Danny Beck.
Nice follow-up by Danny Beck. Offensive board, it's another rebound for the Panthers. They're really beating LaSalle in the rebounding game, which is really shown on those little garbage buckets.
He has 9 underneath his McElroy, underneath the basket. No basket there. Going to get a foul called. And Elder with 2:53 to play here in the game. Elder leads it 59-49. But on the free throw line is Danny McElroy.
In for the 1-1.
McElroy with 9 in the game. Bobby Austin leads the way for LaSalle with 17. Kyle Rudolph has 22 for Elder. Free throw no good. Rebound underneath for Nick Holmes the other way. And setting up Danny Beck. He drives the lane. Into Rudolph, lost it. Picked up the other way for LaSalle. McElroy gets to Schmidt. Schmidt one-on-one up the glass, no good. Rebound tapped, and it's going to be they're going to get a foul by Elder, and didn't like the call.
It was a late whistle is why the call was so rejected. Nick Holmes went in for the step to try to take a charge. The referee under the basket who's supposed to make that call did not blow his whistle. The guy from the backside came in and blew it just a little bit late. That's why there was such a reaction on that call. They'll be at the line now shooting two, and we're looking at a 10-point game.
And Phil, 2:40 to go in this one. Elder with the lead, 59-49. And of course, got a couple of seconds here. Your freshman team did a good job today, along with the JV.
Freshman JV both were successful on the levels. The Elder Panthers are trying to complete the home sweep tonight of the Lancers.
Of course, the same Phil Bengel that coaches the freshman team. That free throw is no good. 2 minutes 40 seconds to go in this one. 59-49. Elder on top by 10. And Tony Schmidt will get another chance here to try to hit this free throw. It's up with a right hand, and this one is good. So Tony Schmidt now has 9 points for LaSalle. The other way for Elder, length of the floor. Kyle Rudolph with the dribble, looking for help. Bounces it in, gets it to Holmes. Holmes triple teamed, and he tried it. It's a jump ball. He was looking for the timeout.
Wow, that was Danny Beck grabbed the ball. He came in. It's got a jump, and he cradled it. He cradled the ball. LaSalle came down and put their hands on it for less than a second, and the referee came in and called a jump ball. A jump ball has to be called after almost 2 seconds of dual possession. That is a quick call by an official, and that's something that could come back to haunt the Panthers, but they did throw the ball into traffic.
59-50. Elder on top. 2 minutes, 33 seconds to go. But Beck will get the possession and the ball in front of the Elder bench. Bounces it in to Ratterman. Ratterman is tough defense by LaSalle here. Setting up Beck, goes right side to Kevin Johnson, who's had a lot of action here tonight. Gets it to Beck on the left point. Beck goes right side, now looks for some help. Bounces it in to Rudolph. Rudolph goes left side, Ratterman. Ratterman lost control, bounces out of bounds, but it's going to go off of LaSalle, I believe.
Yeah, actually, they're going to call foul.
Oh, even
they're
better.
They're going to call foul.
It looked like it went out of bounds, but they called the foul before that, so 59-50, Elder will get
foul,
a chance.
And that foul was called on Vince Harris. Vince Harris, that's his second, so they will be at the line.
Ratterman has 13 in the ball game. Setting up now, looking to give Elder a 10-point lead with this free throw, and it is up and good. So Ratterman now with 14 for the Panthers, and the lead is 10 again, 60-50. It's been a good fourth quarter.
It's been a very good fourth quarter for both teams. They're kind of getting in a groove. It's just exchanging baskets. One team's got to stop the other defensively at some point.
And the free throw is up and good for Ratterman. He now has 15 in the ball game, and Elder's lead is 11, 61-50 with 2:08 to play. Posey drives off the glass, no good. Rebound tapped. Rudolph has it for the Elder Panthers the other way. Gets it to Ratterman, crossing the timeline, and does. Bounce pass to Johnson. Johnson now bounces it to Ratterman. Ratterman steps on the foul line and had it knocked away. It's picked up the other way. Tried to get it in to Hanghold and didn't make it. That's up. It's stolen away. Ratterman done, but it went out of bounds. It'll be LaSalle basketball.
That's a good hustle play there by Paul Ratterman trying to step up on the lazy pass by the Lancers, which is not what they need right now. It would be a turnover because they need to score on this possession.
Minute 49 to go here in the fourth. Posey, the basketball, right side. Elder leads it 61-50. Posey goes inside now to Austin. Austin, right side. Here's Posey, drives the baseline. Steps it out now. Tony Schmidt. Schmidt now taps it up. Open is Austin. Hits no good. Rebound underneath. Hanghold lost it. McElroy off the glass and in. Danny McElroy now has 11 points in the ballgame, and Elder's lead is 9. Setting up the other way for the Panthers. Going right side. He's got Ratterman. Ratterman steps on the foul line, pulls it back out, gets it to Johnson. Johnson, the basketball for the Panthers. Looks and they're going to call a timeout. With 1:08 to play here in the fourth, we'll take a quick timeout. Elder 61 and LaSalle 52 on the Prep Sports Radio Network. Okay.
Okay.
And the Backstreet Studio Salon and Spa, happy to announce the addition of Mike Little, formerly of J. Michael's Hair Salon, to their staff. Backstreet Studio Spa and Salon, located at 3720 Woodbine Avenue in Cheviot. Give them a call at 662-6559.
And going back very quickly to the freshman and JV game, the freshmen were able to win by 14, and the JV actually won by about 20 yes. Tonight.
Setting up now with a LaSalle and Elder here, 61-52, and Elder brought it in, but they get a foul on Schmidt. Tony Schmidt picks up the foul. That's number two on him.
And these are the thing that people do not realize very much about when you're looking at basketball is these one-on-ones are huge because if you miss the first one, basically you just missed two foul shots, just like right here.
You just missed
except
it.
Nick Holmes comes up with a huge offensive rebound.
Holmes has it in the right corner, gets it out to the side, now gets it to Rudolph. Rudolph steps it up with 54 seconds to play in this one. Now up to McElroy. Check that. That's Danny Beck. Beck the basketball, and they're going to get a foul. Got it into McElroy. Got it in.
And Elder's still just into 1-1. They're one foul away from the double bonus, which is when it's going to create some problems for the Lancers if they continue to foul.
Ratterman on the free throw line. He has 15 in the ballgame. 61-52 Elder. And the free throw is up with the right hand, and this one is good. So 16 for Ratterman over his 12.5 per game average. He had a good game last week against Moeller, a good game tonight as well. Sets up the free throw with the right hand, is up, and it's good. 17 now for him. The lead is 63-52. Elder on top with 42 seconds to play. Posey the basketball for LaSalle. Now goes right side to Schmidt. Schmidt bounces it in and out of bounds. McElroy, it'll be off of Rudolph. So it'll stay LaSalle basketball with 32.8 seconds to play here in this one. Underneath the basket, gets it inbound to Posey. Posey for LaSalle, drives the lane, running left-hander, and it's getting an offensive foul on Posey. No, wait, check that. That's going to go on Ratterman.
It went on Posey. It was an offensive foul. Nick Holmes took a charge there for the Panthers, which is charted as a turnover for the Lancers because Elder will get the ball.
Bovard now goes right side to Ratterman. Ratterman with 24 seconds. Gets it to Bovard. Bovard looks for the basketball, setting up, and now gets it up the top over to Beck. Danny Beck, the basketball, down to 12 seconds, 63-52. Elder is going to win this one. And
they're
go to 4-1.
Just going to hold it out till the clock gets up. A hard-fought game by both teams. Dan Fleming's already shaking hands. It looks like an end of a college football game. They're walking out on the court before it's over.
That is the final score. Elder, 63. LaSalle, 52. We'll take a timeout and wrap this one up from Elder High School. You're listening to the Prep Sports Radio Network.